Okay, you should see the essay, Being a Better Online Reader, on the screen in front of you. And this short video is going to provide you with an example of annotating the text using critical reading and active reading strategies, those same sort of strategies you've been reading about, and the same sort of strategies that I want you to use as you read the course material, whether that material is an essay like this one or your textbook or something else altogether. So this is in Google Docs, and I've tried to use Google Docs in this class as much as possible. And I'm going to shift from editing mode to suggesting mode, so that should show up green on the upper right hand side of your screen. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to start reading this out loud. And when you're doing this at home, you can as well read it out loud or read it in your head. But the key is to read it closely, actively, and critically. And I'm going to start here with the title. Never ignore a title, Being a Better Online Reader. And I'm going to approach this as a student reader. I've already read this essay, of course. I assigned it to you. I know what it's about. But this example will be assuming I'm a student reading this essay for the first time. So bear with me here for a moment. Okay, Being a Better Online Reader. I'm going to use the highlighter tool and highlight that title. And I'm then going to use this comment tool, add comment, and make a comment about the title. As a new reader, this title seems to suggest this essay will be about how to be a better online reader. It seems pretty obvious just from that title. And titles often do that. Make sure you hit the comment button to get the comment to stay. The blue is a link. This will take me to the author information. I'm not going to click on that now, but it's something to realize that you can always provide more info. There's also a date of publication and the publication, The New Yorker, and the date. If you're unfamiliar with The New Yorker, it's worth looking up. But I am going to highlight that as well. I'm going to highlight the date in particular, and make a comment. Published in 2014. So 4 years ago. Is this still relevant? With as quickly as things change, especially technology. This essay happens to have a picture. Not all essays will. But I'm also going to comment on this picture. I'm going to pay attention to the images as I should as a reader. And make a comment here about the picture that this reminds me of my daughter. So I'm making a connection to something I know. I'm going to clarify when she's zoned out on her phone and click the comment buttons for the comment to stay. And I realized up here that I did not make that one, so I'm going to click that one too. All right, first paragraph. I'm not going to read this whole first paragraph, but I'm going to read up the first few lines. Soon after Mary Ann Wolfe published Proust and the Squid, okay, that's a clickable link. I'm not going to click on it right now, but I might on my second read. A history of the science and the development of the reading brain from antiquity to the 21st century. She began to receive letters from readers, hundreds of them. Okay, hundreds of letters from readers for a publication. I'm going to highlight that, make a comment here. Maybe ask a question. Why were readers so interested in this? While the background of the writers varied, a theme began to emerge. The more reading moved online, the less students seemed to understand. Okay, this seems to be a key point. I'm going to change my highlight color so this one really stands out. This is what the whole essay is about, I think. I put it as a question because I'm not sure yet. I'm only 3 lines in. There were the architects who wrote to her about students who relied so heavily on reading, on ready digital information that they were unprepared to address basic problems on site. There were the neurosurgeons who worried about the cut and paste chart mentality that their students exhibited, missing crucial details because they failed to delve deeply enough into any one case. And there were, of course, the English teachers who lamented that no one wanted to read Henry James. Henry James, as a student reader, maybe I don't know who that person is. Again, I'm going to highlight and make a comment. Who is this? Should I know? Does it matter? To the point being made. I think the other key thing here that I might highlight is the fact that there were a whole bunch of different people, different kinds of people responding. So I'm going to change the font color, architects. And then I'm going to change this to, again, neurosurgeons, so that stands out. And then I'm going to change English to English. I'm going to change that to red so it sticks out. So what you see here, and I'm going to stop reading at this point, is annotations, highlights on the text itself, and then comments on the side here. And these comments are the sort of things that are especially important because it shows your engagement with the text, whether you're asking a question or you're pointing something out or you're just making a comment that will help you remember something later. You'll be working through some of these readings with small groups, and you'll see comments from classmates. And so you can respond to those comments. This one, for example, if you see someone post a question, maybe you have an answer to that question, you can type your answer here and click reply. Ultimately, the entire essay should have that, should show that sort of engagement. And as you will see, this sort of close reading of a text, active reading of a text, critical reading of a text is going to help you understand the text even better. This is especially important, not to give away this essay, but this is especially important in the online reading environment because we have, research is showing us that, just as it says here in the blue, the more reading moved online, the less students seem to understand. Our brains have been conditioned to skim more when we read online, and we haven't grown up, a lot of us, with exclusively online reading, so we don't have necessarily the skills to learn how to avoid that skimming. So very, very important first step in this class is learning how to read actively, critically, and how to transfer those skills to the online environment when more and more of us are reading on devices and computer screens and that sort of thing. All right. Thanks for listening to the end, and send me any questions if you have them.